Can AI like ChatGPT write code that actually works? Well, today I'm going to find out just how good it can really be. I've got a Waveshare epaper display and a Raspberry Pi Zero, and I want to turn them into a simple digital photo frame, one that automatically shows random images from a folder I choose. But instead of writing the code myself, I'm going to let ChatGPT handle it. Now, Waveshare does provide a few test scripts, mainly just to check if the display is working, but those are more like diagnostics. So what I am doing here is taking one of these test scripts and asking ChatGPT to clean it up, remove what's not needed, and turn it into a proper Python script that does exactly what I need. And as I go through the process, I will share a few practical tips for getting better code from ChatGPT or any AI coding assistant. So, if you ever want to try something like this yourself, you will know what to expect. So, let's get started. I will send you a file. Please remove any unnecessary parts from it and based on the contents, write Python script that will display a random image from the image directory. The script should check the files in the directory every time it runs and display one image on a Waveshare 7.3 display. The image should be shown continuously after the script finishes running. I plan to run the script using Chrome at a specific time. Below is the file to proceed. Okay, now let's go to GitHub and find this file. This is the original repository from Waveshare Electronics, the manufacturers of my epaper script. On the website there are tests and we can download and run to check if the screen is working properly. Just go to Raspberry Pi Jetson Nano, Python, examples. Yeah, and here are tests for different displays models, and I need 7.3 inch and model F. So open, copy, and we can add it to our conversation in ChatGPT. Okay, the code is ready. We can just copy and run it. Okay, but before I do this, I will show you quickly what step I did on the clean Raspberry Pi image before running the code. So, first I use Raspberry Pi Imager from raspberrypi.com to create the image on the memory card. I choose my Raspberry Pi 2.0 and use the Raspberry Pi OS little 64-bit image and my SD card. I edit the configuration, set basic things like password, login, Wi-Fi network and so on. Of course I enable SSH, but I use just password authentication. That might take some time, so feel free to take a break and enjoy your coffee. Okay, in the meantime I printed out the case for the epaper screen and connected all the pieces together. Once the micro SD card was ready, I could insert it into my Raspberry Pi and of course connect the power supply. Now when everything is connected, you can connect via SSH. On the Waveshare.com you can find all the necessary instructions and a detailed description of what to do next. I will simply execute this command and speed up the recording so you don't have to wait and look at the progress bar. Sudo raspi config and I just enable SPI. Finish. To this command I will add a break system packages. Yes, and that's all. Now I will show you what the test script does. Just need to be into epaper, Raspberry Pi, Jetson Nano, Python, examples folder, and run Python script for your display. Here you can see what's displayed on the screen. Based on this file, ChatGPT created a script that will make my Raspberry work like a photo frame. it will simply launch a random file from the specified folder. Okay, now I will create my new photo frame Python script. I will just copy the code from the ChatGPT. Paste and save. Okay, now I will create a directory to which I will send photos that I will randomly display on the epaper screen. I will send the photos using just scp, all files from this directory, wrong IP address. Yeah, now works. Okay, let me add execution rights. And let's look at the code. Okay, it seems to me that ChatGPT cleaned up the files too much. So it's important to have some idea of what you want to create. Copy. Paste. Okay, one step forward. Okay, my mistake. In the prompt, I use the word image, not images. So the script looks for images in the image directory. Okay, let's fix this. I will change the name of my directory to image and see if it works. Oh, it works. I'm a bit surprised. Yeah, it looks really great in real life. Okay, let's run this one more time. Now, all you have to do is run this command, for example using cron tab, and thanks to this, we have a digital photo frame that displays random image at the time we specified, for example, every 30 minutes. Okay, before we finish, here's a quick bonus. If you want better code from ChatGPT, here is a 7-point checklist that works really well. Be specific about what the code should do. Don't just say write a script. Say exactly what the script needs to achieve. Mention the programming language and version. For example, Python 3 attempt, JavaScript and React or Bash. List any libraries, frameworks or APIs, like Pandas, Boto3, Flask or AWS SDK. Describe the input and the expected output. What kind of data goes in and what should come out? Say what matters most: simplicity, speed, clean style. This helps ChatGPT focus on what's important to you. Ask for comments and explanation, especially useful if you are learning or sharing the code with others. Give context if it's a part of bigger project. For example, this will run inside a Lambda function or used in a web form. You can also just give ChatGPT your working code and ask to improve it, clean it, or adapt it to a new use case. As you saw in the movie, it also works very well. Hope this helps. If you don't want to rewrite the checklist, visit my blog and copy it. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. Don't miss new episode and subscribe to the channel. And if you are looking for more tutorials, visit my blog. See you in the next video. Bye.